Today, I want to start working on one of the most important features of our Laravel e-commerce project, and that's the shopping cart. The shopping cart that I chose is the Laravel shopping cart, and this is from Bumbummen99. Hope I'm saying that right. But basically, it's a fork of Crinsane's, which is also a popular Laravel shopping cart package. It's a fork from that, and they do seem to maintain it pretty well. So that's the one that we're going to be using. If we scroll down a little bit, we can take a look. It's basically an easy installation. We have to publish some vendor files, and then it's got a load of contents that you can take a look at. And it's basically just how to use it, which functions work with the package that we're bringing in, how to use it, if you want to add products, if you want to remove products, update them. Basically anything that you could need to do, this is some pretty good documentation to help you get through that. So let's go ahead and start installing this. Let's head up to the start so we can grab that composer require command, and then we can open up our terminal, paste that in, let's also publish that config file, Now, what that did was gave us a new file in our config. And so basically, what you can do is you can just set your default in here. This is the calculator class that it's using to calculate everything. You can set your tax. The default is set to 21. I'm going to go ahead now while I'm here, and I'm just going to put in my tax code. And then you can scroll down. These are the connections that it'll be making if you wanted to add the cart to your database. If you go down, you can destroy and log out, false. Basically, it's just going to be, you can set this to true or false. So every time a user logs out, if they're an authenticated user, it will go ahead and maintain that the cart still stays in the session. And then you also have the formatter where you can decide if you want to format with decimals, if you want to have a thousand separator, which to be honest, it's fine. It's a good function, but considering our prices are just pure integers in our database, we don't need this thousand separator to be here because we're just going to format it on the front end. So we can go ahead and get rid of this. And now that should be good. Now we can set this up so that we can start testing it out before we implement it for our products. So let's go ahead to the web routes, and then in our cart section right down here, we can have another one. We'll say post, cart, this will be store. So now we can head into our cart controller and head down to that store method because that's what we're going to be using. And then let's just go ahead and grab some code from that documentation. Okay, let's go down, and then for now we can just use this one. Okay, let's import this, and we are using shopping carts. We need the facade, and then in our cart show page, our shop show page, let's head up to the form. It starts right here. Okay, we already have our form information in here, so we need a method. And we'll call it submit. The method that we have is cart store. We're going to pass in the form. We're going to do, let me move this up a bit. We'll do preserve. Scroll is true on success. And we'll just leave it blank for now. So before we try this out, there's one more thing that I want to do. I'm going to give this a variable. And so then once this information is added to the cart, we'll die and dump cart just so that we can make sure that there's something coming through. So when we click add to cart, then we should be getting at least the information that we just put in that cart. which we are. And as you can see, it has its own row ID, its own ID. We have a quantity, product one, with options as well. And we will be using that options functionality. But you can also see the tax rate that we put into the config file. And that's exactly what we put in through the controller. All of this information is what we just put into the controller. Fantastic. So now we know that the cart is working. Now, something that this cart does, which I also really do like, is that it allows you to have multiple kinds of carts. So for the main cart, it's just going to be a standard default. But when we get into creating a cart to save things for later, it's going to be a separate cart. So let me scroll down to where that is in the documentation. And you see here, we have instances. For the main cart, for the default instance is gonna, we don't need to put that in here, but because we are using multiple carts, I do want to put it in there so that we can distinguish them throughout the app and we don't get confused as to which one is which. So that's how we're gonna set it up in our controller. In this store method, I'm gonna say cart instance. And again, this is our default. And then we're going to use the same principles of the add function. In this add function, we're going to have the request ID. We're going to pass in the request name. We're going to have the request quantity, request price, zero. And I'll explain all of these in a minute. We need a total quantity. And that one's going to equal request total quantity. We're going to need our product code. Request product code. We're going to need our image. Slug. Details. That's going to be our request details, and that's all we need for that. So if you take a look at what we just typed in versus what we initially had, we're passing in the ID, we're passing in the product name, we're passing in the quantity, the price, and this last one here is the weight. But our items don't have a weight. What we did was we just brought in the request ID, we brought in the request name, request quantity, request price, then the weight is zero, and then as optional information, we're passing in the total quantity, and that's going to be coming in from the request, the product code, the image, the slug, and the details. And all of that is coming from our request. We'll take care of that in a moment. The other thing that this package allows you to do is to associate the model. So our model is going to be app models product. And that'll attach that product itself to the cart. And that's exactly what we're trying to do. So let's go ahead and we can get rid of this and we can get rid of this. And all I want to do after this goes through is to return redirect. And the route is just going to go to cart index. Now let's make sure that we have everything listed here actually coming in from our request. Now the only thing that we're missing from here is the total quantity. This is going to be the product quantity. So what's going to happen by passing this total quantity is that we'll be able to subtract from the total quantity of the item to make sure that the calculations are correct in the cart when they get pushed forward to the cart page. So let's give this a try. And actually, in order to see it before we even do anything, let's go ahead and do the same thing with the cart variable. Okay, let's head to the browser and check that out. Okay, so let's try to pick two items, add to cart. Okay, so now you see we have the price, we have the ID, the quantity that we just chose with the name of our item, and also our tax rate, as well as the associated product model. If we go to options, we see that we have items in here, which have the total quantity, the product code that we're going to need, the image string, and the slug and the details. And this will come in handy when we get ready to set up our Stripe so that this information some of this information we'll be able to pass into that. So that's another reason why we added into the options. Fantastic. We can go ahead, remove the variable. We can remove this die dump and then just replace this. So now let's make sure that this is heading into our session. So instead of just die and dumping it here, we'll be able to add it to our actual session card. Okay, we'll choose a quantity. Again, we'll try to add to cart. Fantastic. We've been brought to the cart index page. Now, we don't have any of the cart information displaying on this page yet, but we'll take care of that right now. So let's go ahead and head up to the index method up here, the function, and now we can pass that to our front end. So we'll just use the cart instance to do that. We'll call them cart items, and then we'll need the cart instance of default. And then the simple function that we're just going to use from the package is called content, and that should be good. This actually needs a parentheses, then a comma. Now let's bring in this variable into the, this is the show page. We'll bring it into the index and we'll put it at the end of this. Let's give this a try and make sure that we're getting those cart items. We'll head over to our shop page. We'll pick a new item. We'll pick 3, add to cart. Okay, so let's open up our inspect tools. Then we'll open up our view tab. Go to index. And now you see in cart items, remember the first item that we sent into the cart, we already added. So this is just the next one, which is home goods. We haven't removed it from our session yet, but we'll take care of that as well. Here are all the items. You see we have the details, image, product code. And now this is all stuff that we can use to display in here. Let's close this out. So now we need to head over to the cart index page and work from the top to the bottom to start getting this to display. Item quantity price is fine. We can loop over that information from here. Right on this this div class right here, we'll do v4 item index in cart items, and then the key will be index. So this link will now have a route, and this link will be able to go back to that particular item's show page. Item options slug, and I'm missing a closing bracket there. For this link, I also want to add some classes. Class equals, fantastic. Now the image will be no longer this. We'll say plus item options image. The alt will be item name. And that looks good. Then we'll head down to the next div and we're going to have the same route. Item option slug. This span is going to be item name, and this one is going to be item options details. And now we can see what's in our actual cart, hopefully. So let's go back to the browser and check and make sure that these items are coming through. We're just worrying about this section up here, not this section. This is for save for later. Okay, so we're not seeing anything. Let's check our inspection tools and see what's going on. Cart items was accessed during render, but is not defined on the instance. Okay, so let's go see what's going on in our code. Cart items. And that should be what I named it. Ah, I need cart items as a prop. Okay, let's give this a try. Okay, very cool, but our images are not displaying. We'll check why in a second, but we have the home goods 8 and home goods 9. Let's scroll up to the images and make sure that I am putting in the correct image. Okay, one more thing that I can check is in the .env file. This might be why that image isn't displaying as of now. Let's do localhost 8000. And I need a colon here. Okay, so that's restarted. And actually, I think that the images, storage app public images, is the name of the outside folder. So we'll go ahead and put that here. And that should clear that up. It's okay that we put the .env in here because we should have that correct link for our app in here in order for the images to be displayed correctly. That's fine, but let's go and check and make sure that this is right, which it should be because that's the folder. There we go. We have our images back. Fantastic. Okay, so now we have our cart in our project. In the next episode, we will start adding more of the functionality that goes into building this out. If you guys are enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button as it really does help out the channel. I'm going to leave it there for now. I'm going to push all this code up to GitHub, and I'm leaving the link for that down in the description, as well as the playlist for all of the episodes in this series and the links that we use today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.